Nityananam, this is Manitya Shiva Mayananda, and I am very, very excited to share you some beautiful examples of how you can manifest anything that you want in life, and how going beyond your own logic, liberating yourself from your own ideas is so much a part of that. So my guru, Sri Nityananda Paramashivam, has taught this as the science of Kalpataru. That is basically a set of powerful cognitions, powerful understandings about yourself and about life, that when you make them your own and start living that on a daily basis, you will see that you literally can decide whatever you want to manifest and do that. So what do we actually need for that? Well, basically two simple things. You need to be clear on what you want to manifest, because if your space is holding a lot of confusion and different kind of ideas, oh, this would be nice, or maybe that would also be nice, or actually, and this would be great. Like, what you are holding in your inner space then is confusion, and that is also what you will manifest on the in the outside world. You will have bits and pieces here and there and everywhere of manifestations, but not really using your energy efficiently into creation. So that is the first thing to clear out. Be very clear on what you want to manifest. And one short exercise how you can find out what you actually want is just putting it onto a little pressure. Means if you start thinking now, like, okay, let's say I have only 1 week to live. For example, your doctor will tell you you have some of the other kind of disease and you only have 1 week left, nothing to do about it. Then what would you spend that 1 week on? What would you really want to do or experience in that 1 week? And then suddenly you are very clear about what you want in your life. So that is a little exercise to find this first thing out. So now you are very clear on what you want. Then the next step comes in, and that is basically just surrendering every thought that is not aligned to that. So every thought and feeling, I mean, your whole system, your whole biology works into this. It's not only what you think separate from the rest. No, your whole biology thinks. So everything you are is involved into this and needs to just integrate to this what you want to manifest. So how did I do that this week? Well, I had 1 week and then in that 1 week, I actually wanted to translate a huge amount of text. I wanted to translate one of my beloved guru's best books ever written. And that book is 500 pages, the abridged version. So this version, like 500 pages translation, is a huge amount of work, of course. So my logic was actually telling me, forget about it, it's not going to happen in 1 week. But surrendering actively that thought cleaned up the space inside of me again, and I start feeling like, actually, why not? Why wouldn't it be possible? I have seen my guru manifesting so many things that I always thought would not be possible. So he has proven me wrong in my logic again and again and again. So let me not use this same stupid logic to decide for my life. Let me surrender that and be in the space of possibilities and just start working authentically to get it done. Well, I can tell you by now, the whole week is not even over yet, but I am so amazed by the amount of work that we got done. I mean, and even the amount of volunteers that I found that I would jump in and work with me to make this happen. even I came to the conclusion like, oh yeah, actually there was this one book. It is called The Essence of this book. It's kind of a, like a workbook that comes with this book that we are translating now. And actually there was somebody who already translated it. It only needed proofreading. So we're not even releasing after this 1 week one book, but actually two. Because all the whole of the proofreading also I did in this 1 week. So I am so excited about the enormous amount of work that has been going on, and not at even one single second I have felt stressed. I have just surrendered literally every thought of the result. As soon as my mind would go towards thinking about, okay, how much do we still need to do and is that possible? Just immediately, I surrendered that whole question. And surrendering is actually as easy as it sounds. And you just need your awareness to see what is it in your inner space that is stopping you from feeling it's possible, and surrender that. You just tell, okay, existence, I can't use this thought current, so you deal with it. I don't need it. That's all. So I have so much experience this whole week that it is just that kind of a surrendering that you do over and over again that keeps your whole space of possibilities completely clean. Continuously, I was feeling, oh, it's possible. So whatever came in as like a problem or an obstacle, immediately some solution would come. Because that is what is beautifully happening in this space of possibilities. So one of the volunteers would call me and say, oh, my whole computer crashed and the two chapters that I was working on, they're lost. And immediately I was thinking like, actually, okay, let us fix a solution. What about your phone? Could you use your phone and just translate and send it to me in the email? Then I will put it together in a text document. So like that, everything that we sometimes perceive as a drama or an obstacle or something that like makes it impossible or whatever, if you are in that space of possibilities, just continuously solutions keep happening before something actually has become even a problem. So I'm so excited about this. Another example of how this works so beautifully, how it enlarges, enhances the quality of life tremendously. So I wanted to really share with you. So I love to hear also in the comments